Then Georgia's not turning blue.
Georgia is well on its way to solidifying its status as a blue state. Joe Biden will need a lot of help in the Senate.
We are invigorated in Georgia. We need to be able to govern. And that comes down to these two races here in Georgia.
All eyes are on Georgia, where two runoff races will determine the balance of power in the U.S. Senate. Let's talk to one of the four contenders for those crucial Senate seats, Democrat Jon Ossoff. He's hoping to unseat Republican Senator David Perdue, who we invited on the program and hope to have on this week soon. I want to start with the president. Jon Ossoff is up tweeting already about Georgia and many other things. He says, doing a great job in Georgia. Their recount is a scam, means nothing, must see fraudulent signatures, which is prohibited by stupidly signed an unconstitutional consent decree. Want to give me a reaction to that?
Well, Martha, good morning. Thank you for having me. And I suppose they say the first stage is denial. Trump is leaving, whether he knows it or not. And the question now is how we're going to contain this pandemic, which is raging out of control, which is spreading at an accelerating rate. There are hundreds of thousands of lives hanging in the balance. There are millions of jobs and homes and livelihoods hanging in the balance. And that's why it's so important to win these two Senate races so that the incoming presidential administration can govern, can lead, can enact the solutions necessary to contain this virus and invest in economic recovery.
You know, Joe Biden got nearly 100,000 more votes than you in Georgia. What do you think that was about, and how do you make up that gap between now and January?
Well, we saw a little bit of drop-off from the top of the ticket. We saw a few votes go to the Libertarian candidate in the Senate race, but this was the closest Senate race in the country, Martha. And that really reflects the power of black turnout here, the determination of black voters in Georgia to make a change in this country. Georgia's black community has been hit the hardest by COVID-19. Georgia's black community is demanding access to affordable health care, demanding civil rights legislation to secure criminal justice reform. And look, Georgians are about to celebrate Thanksgiving without family. Georgians are looking at a future that is continued to be threatened by the spread of this virus and a very uncertain economic scenario. After 4 years of division that's been corrosive to our national soul, we're seeing record-breaking turnout in Georgia from voters who are demanding change, who are demanding competent, honest leadership out of this crisis.
And yet your opponent, David Perdue, outran you by 90,000 votes, nearly matching President Trump's vote total.
It doesn't worry me at all, Martha. First of all, we are currently organizing and running the largest voter registration and turnout effort in American history. For example, there are 23,000 young people here in Georgia who will become eligible to vote just between the November election and this January 5th runoff. And a decade of organizing, much of this work led by Stacey Abrams, has put the wind in our sails here in Georgia. What we're feeling for the first time in 4 years is hope. Is recognition that with Trump departing, we have the opportunity to define the next chapter in American history, to lead out of this crisis, but only by winning these Senate seats. The GOP at the national level has no leader, has no message, and has no vision other than stopping Joe Biden. But we are in a crisis. We need leadership. We need to make sure that Joe Biden can govern and this administration is successful.
You know, I want to go back to the Joe Biden. He obviously has been projected the winner in Georgia. We know there is that audit underway. But it appears the margin of victory will remain quite slim, about 14,000 votes. Given that narrow margin, is this about an aversion to Donald Trump or enthusiasm for Joe Biden?
There's massive enthusiasm for Joe Biden here. And look, Joe Biden just unseated an incumbent president by the most significant popular vote margin for a challenger since Hoover was defeated by Roosevelt in 1932. And that hope that I was just talking about, that feeling that we have the opportunity now to heal our nation's soul after 4 years of hatred and fear-mongering and division, to empower medical experts to lead us out of this pandemic, to invest in infrastructure and clean energy and economic recovery, and to enact a broader program, a new Civil Rights Act, establishing health care as a human right for all people in this country. This is where we're headed as a country, and Georgians are excited to be a part of it. We recognize that these races in Georgia have national implications. I just finished a 7-city, 4-day tour, and the enthusiasm here is off the charts.
Okay, thank you so much for joining us, and best of luck to you. Good to see you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.